All right, guys, welcome back. So we're gonna do how to negative ASINs. Now, there are a few ways I'm gonna share with you how to negative ASINs in an exact match. Now, this, for some example, a lot of guys don't understand. It is a very simple process. If you don't understand, it's okay. I'm gonna be happy to share with you. So let's look at our ASIN grabber. First of all, let's say, for example, we have a product that we're selling at, I'll just give you a number out of the blue, $17.99. First thing you want to come is download an extension report of the product like we did. So let's go back here to Amazon so I can show you step-by-step process on how to do it. Excuse me. Let's find the same product, the Bento lunchbox. So we're gonna do Bento lunchbox. First thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna type your main keyword. It's gonna give you a list of all the products that's there. You're gonna go into the extension and you're going to run an X-ray report. Not for Walmart, for Amazon. From the X-ray report, once it gives you the information, you see here, X-ray, Amazon product research. Once you get that information, you want to go and you want to download the report. So I've already downloaded it and I'm gonna show you what needs to be done here. So let's say our product is priced $17.99. You have to negative exact the ones that are under your price point. You want to get rid of them, because what happens is if your product is being targeted to a product which is under your price, above your reviews, then there is no way you can sell your product. So you have to get rid of those products. So the first thing that we're going to do is, excuse me, we are going to go under the price right here. So we're going to take this, and anything under $17.99, we don't want. So we're going to do less than or equal to, and here we're going to put 17, let's say 16.99. Anything under $16.99, we don't want. So all of these. Now watch this very carefully, because this works like magic, but it doesn't end here. Whichever campaigns you're gonna create, whichever ad groups you're gonna create, whatever you're gonna create, whether it's auto campaign or a manual campaign, a product targeting campaign, anything you're opening, you have to do this under this particular way. Now we have all of them over here, okay? So we're gonna take all of these ASINs, we're gonna copy them, and we're gonna take it on our on our negative ASINs. So we go here, we're gonna put add a negative exact. Now, in exact, if this is a product, since this is a negative exact for keywords, now remember, you are not gonna get an option. If you put an ASIN over here, the algorithm is not gonna understand. So putting an ASIN in this place is not gonna work at all, okay? An ASIN is not a keyword. An ASIN is a product targeting thing. So what you have to do in this case, instead of negative exact, we are going to change the technique, because we want keywords. We want Amazon to understand keywords, not ASIN. So instead of using the ASIN, we are going to take the brand names. We're going to copy that. And we are going to add negative keyword, but we're not going to do negative exact. Because if you do negative exact, that means somebody actually going and typing the company's name. There's thousands of companies. How would you know which customer would put not? So we do it under negative phrase. And we put all the company names and we add the keywords. Okay, this is one technique. The second technique is that one is to remove the ones that are below your price point. The other one is to remove the ratings, the reviews. So let's say you have 100 reviews and you have competitors that are greater than 100, thousands. So we're going to do, so normally I look for at least 25% up and down. So if we have 100 reviews, I'm going to look for somebody with 125 reviews. That's the most I will go after. So we're going to do 126 reviews. Anything above 126 reviews, I don't want to compete with. Because if we compete with people with that many reviews, then we are throwing ourselves out of business, okay? You take their brand name, and we are going to put it under that same negative keyword phrase match. See? Now, anything that is repeated is automatically going to take it off. And you see, all of these are being repeated. So anytime you are running PPC and you're targeting a product, so anything that is below your price point, negative phrase the brand, and anything that's above your reviews, negative phrase that brand, finishes out of the system. Every time you're running a campaign, make sure to keep a list of these separate so you don't have to go back into the reports and do it constantly, okay? If you're going to use this, so for example, the reason why we do the brand name as negative is because in Amazon, every time you list a product, majority of the time you put the title, you are putting the brand name in front and then the product title. So this already does an escape route, so that it's no longer being targeted. You don't have to worry. And when you're doing procedure like this, you are going to notice your ACOS is going to really, really show you a good approach. Okay, I'm going to cancel this. let's look at, so I hope you understand this is kind of a tricky part. It's actually very simple. It's kind of a tricky one to do. So I hope you understood. And we're going to go to the next chapter. Thank you for watching. Have a lovely day. Bye.